have a fear of growing an ego, because I'm an artist's artist, but I'm also a Muslim. And sure, everybody's meant for a purpose and all, but art can get pretty satanic. Music is haram, and yeah, nobody's perfect, but I have to be honest, I'm too good at what I do. I'm like a modern day Van Gogh. I can recite the Quran off rip, though admittedly I'd also give my ear up for the art. By 26, I've traveled to make a few films, and my savings are barely saving me, but the friends I've met along the way always do.
If he ever, like, fires you, you got a job in
the aura.
Yeah, I got you. Yeah.
Still, I can make more than ends meet. I'd rather not say how I make my living. Evil eye in Islam is called Nazar. But just assume I graduated from a nerdy Canadian school. And it's a biased opinion, but only a smart guy could graduate with a D. It worked for me, but don't get it twisted. I'm a born Texan. Texas. It's where my maternal grandfather settled down. He passed away 8 years ago on January 18, 2016, and on his way to the hospital, he demanded that we put his iPad on charge. You can say that's grim. I say that's where I get my positive attitude. The type of guy who never seemed to go to bed worried or angry, and if he was a pro at not showing it. I wish I'd ask him more questions about his life, my history. I wasn't a mature kid. I didn't know what to ask. And now he's gone. 80 ain't a bad age to go, though. At least he's left me some clothes. My favorites are the button-down and pajama pants. And I'm not glazing my grandpa. They just mean something to me. A reminder of what it is to be a joyous person. And laughing through thick and thin. I contemplate a lot about the year prior. My friend and I had toured the world like a two-man band. Sneako, the content creator. Saqeb, the editor and cameraman. But we were adventurers, really. Chartering 5 continents in 2 months, we stopped from airport to airport like riding a subway. And what came of it was a few exceptional films and a legendary summer of streaming. We started slow in Phuket. Thailand was my favorite. Aside from being overly horny, Bong Bong was an exceptional taxi driver.
Many lady on the way?
Yeah, I did too, yeah.
Okay, later we'll see more lady.
I feel like Bong Bong's trying to get some action.
Yo, Bong Bong's trying to get.
And riding elephants isn't something you just do every day. But neither is adventuring with Arab through the markets of Morocco.
Yeah, same. You know what I mean, dog? You know what I mean?
We haggled with the merchants of Marrakesh, and that was the last I saw him.
3XL?
Yeah.
Bro, I'm not that obese.
That is until I caught him last month in Miami at Sonny's place when he stopped to take a nap on the way to getting kidnapped.
An Arab has been kidnapped in Haiti.
Captured at the hands of a gang ruled under a dude named Barbecue.
I mean, if it's true, man, all of us streamers gotta pitch in and help him, you know?
One guy's name is Arab, but he's a Christian. And the other dude's name is Barbecue. They're both kind of legends. I knew he'd be fine. But streaming really only took off after we came back to the States. And we climbed to the top of it. Summer 2023, summer of IRL streaming. All we needed was a $3,000 backpack connected to a $7,000 camera and a 5G network to go live from anywhere. There's that time in New York when we did interviews in Central Park with Adin Ross.
You won't, though. He's a good guy. I'm sweet. He's a sweet guy. He's a great guy. Buy him something, dude. Really? Buy him a shirt. Come on. I got you, brother.
He bought his friend Jake $12,000 worth of clothes, and I didn't complain when he gave me $300. I also did 4 or 5 streams for Neon. He used to ask me if I wanted anything from Shake Shack. He became one of the biggest streamers in front of my eyes. Being a cameraman had its perks. I did my job and I was likable. At any given moment, there were 10,000, 30,000, sometimes even 70,000 people watching whatever I pointed the camera to. And if you didn't see it live, you saw it that night on Instagram or TikTok. Like a viewer, I'd often look up to enjoy the randomness of the show. One day I'm in the studio with Lil Pump. The next day I'm watching Adin spar Jake Paul. And the next day I'm at Universal Studios holding a Sony A7S III on a roller coaster. Backwards. 100,000 people are watching collectively. I have to get the angle. It's not as easy as you think it is. And I gasped behind the camera that time Bradley Martyn punched Sneako in the face. Like the 260-pound guy almost beat the shit out of me. All because Sneako lit up a cig in his gym.
I'll smash your fucking camera right now.
Honestly, I did hand Sneako the lighter. We had to get revenge. He chipped his tooth. I thought we were cool, Brad. But everyone loved the drama, creators and viewers alike. More drama meant more views, and more views meant more clout. More attention.
They didn't be fit, it's such bullshit.
I recall a day during that monumental run where we took a day off. Instead, the two of us sat for hours on the balcony glued to watching somebody else. Up until that point, FouseyTube had been streaming his life non-stop for 60 plus days. Eating, sleeping, showers. And Sneako caught him for a few streams when he came right to us in Miami. I almost met him, but like I said, we took off that day. I'm glad I didn't. I'm too big of a fan, and he was manic, although it made for a legendary ending. Over 100,000 people watched him get swatted live, moments after he slapped a kid in the face in his own home and proceeded to piss on his lawn. The internet was tuned in. Dozens of police covered the entire block around his hotel room, just minutes away from us. They questioned him. He threatened and cursed at them. Like a scene out of a movie, the show was recorded to a literal end. They cuffed Fousey and locked him up in a mental institution. By the end of it, he looked like an angry and irritable person who wasn't doing anything for himself and everything for the views, at the expense of someone, a loved one, whatever kept his show rolling. He wasn't Batman, he was the Joker, letting go of his sanity for our entertainment, and everybody clapped. Why did everybody clap? Last night I dreamt in pitch black. I was holding a hand, smaller than mine. For hours we held on and played with our fingers. A faceless, feminine soul. I recognized her from other dreams. As if I've dreamt many adventures with them, but they cut themselves from the memory. Every time, without fail, before I wake up. It's intimate, in the little ways. A reason to become a man, more disciplined. And for making an effort to smoke less, the day that I'll see her, the lifetime that I'll take care of her. Our adventures bring me joy, like boy. He's only 10 months old. For a while, I thought about not cutting his balls off. He's like my son. Does my son dream about somebody like me? I didn't want to kill his inspiration. Then he escaped out the window one night the moment I wasn't looking. A quick Reddit search told me they'll go hundreds of miles for a mate that's not even a wife. So I made a trip to the vet when he came back the next day. I adopted boy after I hung my gloves up. I was grateful to Sneako, and my cameraman days weren't over. But my lens of the world changed entirely. I thought back to my grandpa and what it meant to have real joy in my life. Was that the happiness I was looking for? Was that what a fulfilling life entailed? Sleepless nights, ruthless spending, life on the go. Like Fousey, I was more angry, irritable, constantly working and out of shape. I had more wealth, but less time. And my sense of gratitude slipped. A world of drama. It's hardly admirable. Surrounded by the glitz and glamour of influencers and their money, I grew to see them for the humans that they were. In the pursuit of something bigger, worldly desires can make them compromise, and friends they cared for can get stepped over. For the result of what? For the attention of who? It felt unfulfilling to be around. Maybe it takes a lot to have a clean heart. A different journey entirely that requires you to stop yourself and ask, who am I becoming?
People say that all the time, you know? Oh, he's a mental fighter, emotional fighter. I don't even know what that means.
This is MMA fighter Nate Diaz, one of the biggest stars in UFC history. More than his win over Conor McGregor or his infinite love for ganja, he's known for his give-no-fucks attitude and his uncanny delivery that takes playful wit.
Assalamu alaikum, my niggas.
Cappuccetti introduced me to his buddy Nate when we met up in New York. I shook hands with Nate's hometown friend from Stockton. This was a close group of five or six people, genuine bonds between guys who came up together. Family ties, as Cap always says. And at first, Nate himself didn't seem to like me. I was an outsider. When I told him that I used to work for influencers, I could tell that he had his own answers to the world I'd been questioning. And maybe he didn't see it, but he must have felt it in me.
Eat your vegetables.
Work slipped the conversation and we hit it off. He told me about his new music studio, and I gave him a couple of Eminem beats to freestyle. Our characters carried the conversation. Who we were outside of that room didn't matter. Nate was much different than most celebrities I'd met. He left me with a nickname only he could conjure up. Sakuchi, like Gucci. That's the nomenclature he used when we hung out again last month. Nate's got 6 million followers. He could be with Peso Pluma, or he could be with me. Despite having the attention of the globe, he chose to be grounded around real friends. And what I've discovered about myself from meeting folks like him is that my biggest inspirations in life are the ones that I know. That's why I couldn't clap for Fousey. In a pursuit to appease strangers on the internet, he lost sight of the souls that fulfill you more than money. A greatness to them that doesn't need fame. I want to become great like my grandpa, And since I've known him, I want to become great like Nate. A fighter who speaks genuinely, doesn't hide or sugarcoat anything, and 100% committed to living life on his terms. He seems happy. Now that's admirable.